A new generation of communication satellites is bringing internet service to parts of the world that have never had access to it before. These new low Earth orbit satellites began providing service only in 2020, but in just a few short years since, there has been a tremendous amount of innovation in the technology. Hi, my name is Ricky, an engineer here at Mouser Electronics. Welcome to Need to Know, where we break down key technologies, engineering fundamentals, and the latest breakthroughs shaping science and innovation. Here's what you need to know about satellite internet. The first communication satellites were placed in geosynchronous Earth orbit over 35,000 kilometers high, each covering one third of the planet. Medium Earth orbit, or MEO, is no farther than 20,000 kilometers above Earth. Most navigation and positioning satellites, for example, are in MEO orbits. Depending on the orbital high, dozens might be required for full coverage. The latest generation of satellites, including all the ones used for new satellite internet services, are in low Earth orbit, or LEO, at altitudes under 2,000 kilometers. Orbital mechanics dictate that LEO satellites typically complete a full orbit in about 90 to 120 minutes, depending on their altitude. This means that to maintain continuous coverage of any specific geographic area, multiple satellites are needed, forming what's known as a constellation of satellites. No satellite internet service today covers the entire Earth, but Starlink currently operates the most extensive constellation, with more than 7,000 satellites. This map shows Starlink's land coverage, but satellites are also uniquely capable of extending internet coverage to both ships at sea and to aircraft. For satellite-based internet service, orbiting more satellites will translate into some combination of the following benefits: wider coverage area, expanded capacity, and greater redundancy. Subscribers use phased array antennas that electronically steer their beams to connect to a satellite passing overhead, which relays data streams to and from ground stations that in turn relay traffic to the network at large. When a subscriber is connected to a satellite that is about to go out of range, the connection gets automatically passed to another satellite that will remain in range for a while longer. Here is one of the recent innovations in satellite internet. Several constellation operators have begun equipping their satellites with laser-based inter-satellite communication systems. Satellite-to-satellite connectivity turns a constellation into a mesh network, with all of the same advantages that a Wi-Fi mesh network has in your office or home, including better coverage and improved reliability. For operators, a mesh network also adds flexibility by allowing satellites to relay data directly to one another, reducing dependence on ground stations and improving redundancy. Another major innovation comes from updates to the 5G New Radio Non-Terrestrial Network, or NR-NTN standard. This defines how standard 5G devices, including smartphones and IoT sensors, could connect directly to satellites without the need of specialized hardware. As satellite constellations expand, this could dramatically extend 5G coverage to remote areas, oceans, disaster zones, enabling seamless global connectivity for both personal communications and machine-to-machine IoT networks. Finally, recent innovations in GEO satellites could allow them to work closely with LEO satellites to provide combination services that take advantage of their respective strengths. The proposal is to have LEO satellites provide global, fast, low-latency internet, while GEO satellites use their high-capacity capabilities to service high-population urban areas for non-time-sensitive applications. To learn more about satellite internet, check out this article on our website. You can also explore our technical library, which has articles on a wide range of topics. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up on what you need to know.